Hello and welcome back to our YouTube video tutorial concentrating on the HTML. In the previous video tutorial, we made a table of HTML and it was displaying information like this, okay? Like this. So in this video tutorial, we're going to learn how to format a table to really look like a table by putting borders and formatting it as exactly how you want. So let's begin.
Audio Jungle.
A table and formatting, maybe putting it a border, we need some styles. We need some style. We cannot do it without just with CSS. So we need some styling, which will help us to specify that the border that the table should be having a border. So to do that, we first come here in the head. Okay, we can just do it generally by coming in the head, then specify the tags that want them to be having border. For example, we want the table itself to be having a border. We want the table row to be having a border, table head to be having a border, and the table data to be having a border. So let's begin by putting table. So we just write style first, okay? Because it's going to be CSS attributes. These are attributes of CSS. You can delete this if you don't mind. Then you come here and start specifying. For example, we say the word. That table element itself, we want to do what? To make it a border, to have a border. Then you put a comma, we put another element. Another element that wanted to have a border is a table table row, which is TR, okay? And another element that want to have a border is the table head, which is TH. Another element that we need to have a border, it is a what? It is the table data, which is TD, okay? So those are the elements that need to have a border. We place them in that form and put them, we separate them with commas. So we put a curl bracket and start writing the CSS or the styles. So to write a border, a border style, we just say border, okay? And when you're writing a border, you have to specify three things: the border color, the border style, and the border size. I repeat, when you're writing a border, you have to specify three things: the border color, the border style, and the border size. So now, for example, the border color, we may put any color, maybe black. The arrangement doesn't matter. We may begin with black, and then we put the size. How many pixels? Maybe 3 pixels. So it means that our line that we're going to create for this table, each line will be having 3 pixels as the border. Then later, what next? We have to specify the style. There are three styles of HTML borders. There is dashed, there is dotted, and solid. Dashed is a bit like dots, which are a bit wide, and then dotted, they are dots, and then solid is just a solid line with no any separation. So let's begin by putting solid and see what will happen. So it means that if you put solid, then you put a semicolon. Those are the three attributes that a border takes of CSS at this point. So it means that each table head, each table attribute with and the table row and the table head and the table data are going to be having this border. So let us go and see how it works. You can see it's having, each of them is having a border. So that's how we've made it. But a real world table is not always like this. These are just boxes and they're not combined. You can see these are rows that we are creating, but these are just boxes that are not combined. So to combine these ones to make them collapse and be one line other than just separate boxes, we come back here and put one more attribute, which is called border collapse. Then you put collapse. Those are two attributes that you put. Please, if your Sublime text is not suggesting words, please go to a video where we discussed how to install packages of Sublime Text. When you watch that video, you'll understand how to do what, how to make it suggesting for you the classes and HTML attributes. So we put this border collapse, then we pass the attribute of collapse, then the result would be like this. As you can see, it has been collapsed, and that's the result. It's like now a real table. So I hope you now understand how we make a table in HTML. Let us meet in the next video. We are going to look at the table span, row span, and the column span. I hope you'll not miss, and please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. When you subscribe to our YouTube channel, we get more morale of making more videos of this kind. So, and don't forget to like and share. Thank you for watching up to this point.